Hello students. Today we'll learn about encryption. There are two main approaches to network security. The first approach uses cryptography. This involves cryptographic algorithms and security protocols. The second approach focuses on system security. This doesn't involve encryption. It includes firewalls, antivirus software, intrusion detection systems, and similar tools. Together, they create a comprehensive security framework. So what is encryption? Encryption converts readable text into scrambled, unreadable code. The encrypted text can be decrypted back to its original plain text. This distinguishes encryption from hashing. There are two types of encryption. The first is traditional encryption, also known as symmetric encryption. It uses the same key for encryption and decryption. The second type is public key encryption, also called asymmetric encryption. It uses different keys for encryption and decryption. Let's cover some encryption basics. Encryption algorithms work with binary strings, sequences of zeros and ones. Any message made up of fixed symbols can convert to a binary string. Take SCI code for example, American Standard Code for Information Exchange. Each letter converts to a 7-bit binary string. To keep processing simple, encryption should use simple operations only, like adding, subtracting, multiplying, XOR, substitution, modulo. We avoid using division. For a binary string X, we write X to show X's length, which counts the number of bits in X. Let X have length L. Then X is a bit binary string. Let it be a bit, and k in a negative integer. A k represents k copies of bit A, formed by concatenating k copies of A. We denote concatenation as XY. To join strings X and Y, now let's look at ASCII code, a 7-bit binary code. Codes 132 are control characters. Codes 32126 contain letters, numbers, and symbols. We typically add a leading bit to form a complete byte per character, making it an 8-bit sequence. This extra bit enables 128 additional characters, or acts as a parity bit for error checking. Therefore, all ASCII codes have lengths divisible by 8. As for other encoding systems, like Unicode with its 16-bit divisions, for our purposes, we assume all plain text lengths are multiples of 8 bits. Now for the simplest encryption method, the substitution cipher. Let's talk about substitution ciphers. It works by replacing each letter with a different one. For instance, A becomes D, B becomes C, and C becomes T, and so forth. To the untrained eye, the encrypted message appears completely scrambled. However, this method has a weakness. It maintains the original pattern of letter frequencies. In English, the letter E appears most frequently. Therefore, the most common letter in the encrypted text is probably replacing E from the original message. Using this method, we can figure out how other letters are substituted. Let's look at another simple encryption method. This is called the XOR cipher. XOR stands for exclusive or operation. It's the simplest way to encrypt binary data. In XOR encryption, we first split the data into blocks of equal length. Then we encrypt each block using a key of the same length. Let's look at an example. In this example, we have a two-character string M to encrypt. We'll use an 8-bit key. We'll encrypt M twice. This gives us our ciphertext. The ciphertext C corresponds to the original message M. In XOR encryption, we can decrypt using the same key by XORing C with K. We recover the original message M. Here's our ciphertext C. And after XORing it with key K, we get back message M. XOR is simple to implement, but not secure. It's vulnerable to known plaintext attack, meaning with just one MC pair, we can find the key K. Let's look at how this works. Here's a plaintext ciphertext pair. We XOR the plaintext with its ciphertext. Remember that CI don't you mean XRK. Now XOR the result with me. Based on XOR properties, XORing identical values gives us 0. So we end up with key K. What does this mean? It means an attacker only needs one plaintext ciphertext pair. This allows attackers to derive the encryption key. This is what we call a known plaintext attack. It uses intercepted pairs of plaintext and ciphertext to crack the encryption key. How can we protect against such attack? By implementing a one-time pass system. We've covered the basics of encryption. That concludes our encryption lesson.